massive party at my friend's house that night, and the whole school was going to be there. I dropped June off at her friend's house and joined Philip at the party. I'd been there for only an hour when suddenly the music turned off. I looked up to see Mom standing on stage. Sophie, where are you? Mom, June just got into a huge fight at her friend's house. How could you put a party over your own sister? You're so selfish. My jaw hit the floor. The whole school was watching as Mom marched me back to her car where June was sitting in tears. Why would you get into a fight? She called me an insect and they broke my glasses. See? Did you hit her hard? I broke her nose. Good girl. She defended herself. She's okay, Mom. Nothing is okay. I had to go get her because you wouldn't pick up your phone. And now I have to spend thousands of dollars to buy another one of those ugly glasses. Her classmates hate her even more now. Is this what you wanted? Of course not. Do you like that you're popular while your sister keeps getting bullied? Stop it. None of that is true. I knew Mom was wrong, but everything she said made me feel so guilty. Why did I have to go to that stupid party? Mom grounded us both for the entire summer break, and Philip came over to meet me at home.
You got grounded just for going to a party?
Well, I left June alone.
So? You're her sister, not her mom.
You don't get it. I knew she had trouble making friends. I should have been there for her.
You're literally with her every second while your mom's always busy.
She's a single parent. She has to work.
She can't find a babysitter? For some reason, she makes you do everything for her. She embarrassed you in front of the whole school, and then she grounded you? Sophie, she sounds terrible.
I gasped and slapped him. You can't say that to me. She's the only parent I have. Tears filled my eyes, and I stormed away from him. If he couldn't understand my family situation, I didn't want to be with him. I was too thick-headed to see how right he was. Until one day, when I was in the 11th grade, and the school principal called me to his office. June was there too. What happened now? They told me that June was a genius. She had a 145 IQ. Wow!
She can go to any school for gifted kids in the country with a full scholarship. And June has chosen the school in New York City.
What? Why New York? Isn't there a school in our state? Yes, but I choose New York. I pulled June aside after the meeting. You want to go away? Why? Why should I stay here? So you and Mom can keep being embarrassed of me? What? I love you, Sophie, but I'm tired of being the blind idiot you're forced to take care of. June, you're my sister. I do things for you because I love you. I've seen you lose friends and boyfriends for me, while Mom acts like I don't even exist. I'm sick of being a burden. I'm leaving. You and Mom can finally be free.
I was numb with shock. June was gonna be alone in another state. My relationship with Mom was beyond repair, and June was packing up all her stuff. Everything in my life was falling apart. One day, June brought me to her room, and Philip was sitting inside. What is this?
I'm leaving now, and you're Sophie's next best friend. So stop fighting. Work it out.
She locked us in her room.
The little minx. Well, you were right. My mom is a terrible person, and I was an idiot.
You weren't an idiot.
You were the only one who was nice to June, and I was horrible to you. I'm so sorry, Philip.
You were dealing with a lot, Sophie. I understand. And June's leaving now?
I just don't know how she's gonna live without me. I feel scared.
She'll be fine. Look at this.
He showed me the pamphlets and website for the school, and once I calmed down, the place looked amazing. They had so many fun activities, and there was a whole section just for differently abled students. Some kids in the photos were wearing glasses just like June's. Suddenly, I knew I had to let her go. When June came back to her room, I pulled her into a tight hug. I wish I could keep you with me forever, but I think this school is a good choice. You deserve better than this stupid town. Really? I just wanted to stop being a burden to you. Don't you dare call yourself that again. You were never a burden to me, June. You'll always be the greatest gift I ever got. Oh, Sophie, I love you. I love you more. I love you most.